Thwaites Glacier is one of the fastest changing systems in Antarctica. It's located in a place of western Antarctica where it's kind of the coastal buffer between ice that's already floating in the ocean and a whole bunch of ice behind it. So the ITGC, which is the International Thwaites Glacier Collaboration, is this big project between the US and the British to get everybody's instruments and everybody's perspectives on this really fast changing system. The grounding line is this place where a glacier meets the ocean. So it's sliding off the continent, hits the ocean, and that place where the ocean, the seafloor, and the ice meet is called the grounding line. It's the first place that in Antarctica, when the water is warming up and starting to affect the ice, that's the first place that the ice and the ocean start to interact. And we've never really been able to measure what's going on in this really important place. And so Icefin was developed in part to be able to get us to those places that aren't reachable by any other means. Icefin is basically an underwater oceanographer, a robotic oceanographer. It's an ROV, which means a remotely operated vehicle. And so its purpose is to take instruments that we commonly use to understand glaciers and the ocean and how it's changing, and then kind of put it on a mobile platform and take it everywhere underneath a glacier. As the glaciers are moving, as they're moving backwards and retreating, they leave a record of that on the seafloor. As they're melting, there's a record of that on the surface of the ice. And so by using all of these instruments together, you get a much more holistic picture of what's going on.
At Thwaites Glacier, we worked with the British Antarctic Survey, and they used a hot water drill to make a hole through about 500 meters of ice. And then we have to lower ice in very carefully through that hole. And then we were able to drive it out about 2 kilometers from there. We're looking at the temperature of the water and how fast the water is moving and the shape of the ice, because those things all impact how much heat goes from the water to the ice. So those are some of the main physical parameters that we're looking at and mapping with Icefin while it's underneath the glacier.
You know, while those data were collected, you can see like parts of the ice raining sediment out as it melts. You get to see these different formations with the video footage that's indicative of turbulence and therefore strong melting. But then we're able to back up what's visualized. You know, no one else would have been able to collect that. So kudos to Brittany for having the vision to create Icefin and then to navigate it in a very bold manner. to collect these kind of data. And so with those data, we're able to say something very meaningful about how the ice is melting in different ways, right?
Glaciers aren't just one piece that matters, it's the whole system. But what we were missing was this picture of exactly what's happening right at this really critical place. So we don't have any data until this field campaign of what's going on at the grounding line of a major glacier ever. And so by being able to go in there and say, okay, this is exactly how this works right in this system, then we have this piece of the puzzle that we didn't have before. We're bringing down things we built to go places we haven't been before, and so it's very challenging, and I think that then inspires your work when you get home as well. So, you know, science is, you know, the search for kind of truth and facts and things like that, but it's still a very human experience. And so that's a big part of working in a place like this, is it takes so many people and it's really kind of coming together that makes that work out. That's why you build things like this at a university. You have creative people, you have a chance to work across disciplinary boundaries, and that's part of what appeals to us about being here at Cornell.